tried to arrange these elements in a very different way. By that time, only 56 elements were discovered. So he tried to arrange all these elements in such a manner that if elements are arranged in the order of their increasing atomic masses, every eighth element would be similar to that of first. In the same way, every eighth element will repeat the same property and will be similar to that of first. In this type of classification, number 8 is very important because every eighth element repeats the property or resembles to its immediate first. He arranged these elements in 7 rows named after Indian musical notes. In the Indian musical system, there are 7 notes: sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, and again sa. In the same way, in Western musical system, there are 7 notes: do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, and again do. So this law was named as law of octaves. The word octa has been derived from a Greek word octa, which means 8. Now let me tell you an easier way to learn a part of this table so that it would be easier for you to learn it. Let's see how. Hefkal konni bar, linak si urab, bmg kezin sir, belkrai si en la, si sae ti in zir, npmns, osfse. Come on, once again. Hefkal konni bar, linak si urab, bmg kezin sir, belkrai si en la, si sae ti in zir, npmns, osfse. In spite of being a good attempt, Newland's law of octave was discarded. Let me tell you why. Newland tried to make a permanent table which contained 56 elements because at that time only 56 elements were discovered. And Newland assumed that only these 56 elements are existed in nature. But after the discovery of more and more elements, this law became irrelevant, because all the other discovered elements could not get accommodated in Newland's classification table. As you already know that Newland divided his classification table in 7 rows, and every 8th element again starts by the very first row. By this way, every 8th element again gets place in the same row and makes a group. Newland strongly emphasized that all the elements in a group possess similar properties. Let's take first group of Newland's classification table as an example. This group contains hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, cobalt, nickel and bromine. Let's discuss about their properties. Hydrogen is gaseous in nature. Fluorine and chlorine are halogens but strongly non-metals. On the other hand, cobalt and nickel are metals. So you can see by yourself, in the similar group, similar elements are dissimilar in properties. That is why this law became discarded. But later it was founded that this law was applicable to initial elements only up to calcium. One more big anomaly was also noticed in his table, that in order to fit elements into his table, Newland adjusted 2 elements in the same slot or position into his table. You can see that cobalt and nickel are placed together, while cerium and lanthanum also are placed at the same position. Due to these anomalies, Newland's law was completely disapproved. But now there was a strong need of classification of elements. At that time, a Russian chemist, Mendeleev, came into light and contributed to this field. When Mendeleev started his work, 63 elements were known. He not only arranged all these elements on the basis of their increasing atomic masses, but also examined the relationship between their atomic masses and their physical and chemical properties. For chemical properties, Mendeleev examined oxides and hydrides of each and every element. That means he made compounds from the combination of each and every element with oxygen and hydrogen. Suppose we take sodium, its oxide will be Na2O. Because valency of sodium is 1 while that of oxygen is 2. Similarly, its hydride will be NaH because the valencies of both these elements are 1. Likewise, he made compounds of each and every 63 elements known till that date. He then took 63 cards and on each card he wrote down the properties of each element. After then, he sorted out the elements with similar properties and pinned them together on the wall. He observed that the elements with similar properties were arranged in their increasing order of atomic masses. Similarly, he observed that there was recurrence of their physical and chemical properties. On the basis of his observations and examinations, he formulated a law which states that the properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic masses. This law became very famous because it tried to remove a number of anomalies left by previous scientists. He is considered as the most important contributor to the early development of classification of periodic table. That is why he is known as father of classification of elements. In our next video, we'll discuss about features and limitations of Mendeleev's periodic table. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.